Hello, I'm Mark Seitman, president of the Media Center for Art, Education, and Technology Foundation. We're pleased to bring you once again the Bronco World Series from Monterey, California. We're able to do this because of the most generous support from the Hardin Foundation, the Arts Council, Monterey County Office of Education, and other numerous and generous supporters. Our mobile broadcast unit will allow us to video and televise artistic and sporting events throughout the county. This mobile broadcast unit will also help us train the media students for tomorrow. Also note, this broadcast is entirely produced by local area students. Please help support our efforts to bring the best in student academic achievement, arts and sports to Monterey County residents. To be a donor, log on to MCAET.org. Let's play ball.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Jack's Park in beautiful Monterey, California, where we have a sunny day for this baseball game for the 19th year in a row, the Pony League Bronco World Series is here at Jack's Park in Monterey. The umpires have gathered at home plate. The introductions of the two teams have been made. And we're just about ready to start this baseball game between Taipei, Taiwan, and Tamiami, Florida. Teams have come here from all over the world, and you can't get much farther apart than Taiwan and Miami. As we start with the first batters, you will note that Taipei, Taiwan is in blue, and Tamiami is in red, and the Tamiami team is taking the field as we speak. So we should be having baseball here very shortly, as soon as the pitcher completes his warm-ups. And the pitcher for Tamiami is Robert Turan. And he's warming up with the catcher number 17, Pedro Pajes. And as the infielders are throwing the ball around in their warm-ups, we'll try to get you the lineups for these teams as quickly as possible. The leadoff batter for Chinese Taipei will be number one, Zhu Xuan Huang. He's taking his warm-ups in the on-deck circle. The umpire has stepped out to tell the pitcher that was his last warm-up, and the practice throw through to second base. Rolls a little bit out to center field, so we'll have a slight delay. And then we'll be ready to go.
Well, Wally, it's certainly a great day for baseball here in Monterey. Excited to see this game four, first game for both teams this weekend.
Matt, you're absolutely right. This is just a gorgeous day, but this is typical of our summers here, where we're blessed with this kind of weather. And the first pitch is low and outside for ball one, and this game has started. The team from Miami, and that's a beautiful strike. The team from Miami must be energized by this cool weather. Where they come from, the heat humidity index is over 100. So they've dropped 40 degrees in their cross-country trip. Low and away. Two balls and one strike. Outside for ball three. The dimensions here conform to Pony League standards, and we'll give them to you in a minute. Strike two for a 3-2 count. It's 225 feet down the line to the temporary fence, left field line. Outside ball four.
Wally, that was a really great at-bat there for the for Chinese Taipei's pitcher. Really patient and said, you know what, I'm going to make you throw strikes. And
absolutely.
Walked on five pitches. Check that, on six pitches.
I have a sneaking suspicion that the Chinese Taipei team is talented, gifted in the fundamentals. Number one, Wang, the second baseman, is the batter. Fake throw to first. And we were talking about the dimensions. Straightaway center field is 250 feet. Stolen base by number five, Wang.
Wally, the early signs looks like Chinese Taipei might be playing a little National League ball today. Looks like they're being patient, trying to manufacture some runs and steal second, move the runner over into scoring position.
The count of the batter is one ball and two strikes. And he's probably looking to hit the ball to the right side to advance that runner to third. Check swing, ball two. Second baseman's giving the runner a little bit of a hassle out there. Change up high and inside. And that's a called strike three. Chest high on the outside corner.
To be honest, they're really putting the pitcher to the test here at Chinese Taipei, as he's had to throw 12 pitches to get those, and he's seen two batters, only one out in 12 pitches.
I think the Monterey pitcher is going to have to keep the ball as low as he can on these rather diminutive players from Chinese Taipei. To finish out the dimensions, the right field line is exactly the same as the left field foul line, 225. Now there's a fastball where he wants it, right at the knees. And the count's 1-1. A little bit high, 2-1.
Wally, as you mentioned earlier, I think weather was a factor for some of these teams in their qualifying rounds. But probably not so much today. It's cool in the I would say upper 60s. Slight breeze here going out to right.
It's just a gorgeous day.
It's a great day for baseball.
The Miami pitcher, Turan, seems to be just missing that strike zone. Fouled away. Back and over the backstop and the stands.
Wally, that's really the first real cut we've seen from a Chinese Taipei player, and here it is, you know, nearly 20 pitches into the first inning.
Absolutely. A first contact that I remember. Oops.
There we go.
Nice pitch inside corner, and he struck him out. And here's the cleanup batter for Chinese Taipei, number 11, Huang, who's the first baseman. Zhu Ling Wang. And if I'm mispronouncing some of these names, you'll have to forgive me. Ground ball foul. No balls and one strike.
to be honest, it's almost like the managers have finally given the swing away permissions to the batters. It felt like the first two batters we saw, there were no swings at the ball. And now all of a sudden they're saying, all right, go ahead, take a shot at it.
Exactly. Low and outside. And that one's fouled off into the tennis courts to our far right. Robert Turon got off to a bit of a shaky start, walking the first batter he faced, but since then he seems to have settled down, and he's throwing strikes, and there's one. Ground ball to the shortstop, and a beautiful stretch by the first baseman, number 19, Vinny Castillo. Excellent play by the shortstop going into the hole.
That was a deep toss, and to be honest, I'm not sure he had enough on it to get it there in time, but he was able to beat the runner with it.
Very impressed.
And Robert Turon for Tamiami had a 22-pitch first inning. Probably not the start he was hoping for, but the Chinese Taipei batters really made him work to get the job done.
They certainly did. I know as a former first baseman, I always preferred to have a ball above my head that I had to reach for than one in the dirt that I had to scoop. And that throw was just about right for that tall Vinny Castillo, the first baseman for Tamiami.
Well, I got to say, I was really impressed in warm-ups. We got here early enough. We had a chance to be down on the field today. Field's in great shape. The dirt looks good. The grass looks good. I think the mound's in pretty good shape. I think the pitchers are going to have a good time there. But the warm-up routine for both teams was really impressive today. I thought they took their time. They got used to the sun, used to the wind, used to the conditions out on the field.
As we were watching the Chinese Taipei players warm up in right field, Matt and I couldn't help but notice what strong arms they have. Seem to be throwing the ball 300 feet with very little effort.
Yeah, I agree, Wally. Certainly their size of the player does not matter. There are some pretty diminutive guys on both teams that had a heck of an arm on them. And like you said, we're tossing. It seemed pretty effortless. More important than the distance was the accuracy with which they were throwing that 300 feet. And it was right on. The guys looked relaxed. The guys looked confident. And I think it's shown early on, certainly in the fielding that we saw so far out of Tamiami.
And we're heading into the bottom of the first inning. And the pitcher for Chinese Taipei is number 5. Zhu Sua Huang.
From the great state of Florida, Tamiami, the home team coming to bat.
And he'll be facing
center fielder, Tyler Perez.
The Tamiami center fielder, number 3, Tyler Perez, a left-handed batter. And he takes high for ball 1. Right on the outside corner.
First lefty batter we've seen of the day. Interesting that all the Chinese Taipei guys hit from the right side of the plate.
Low and away for ball 2. And a swinging strike for strike 2.
Interesting. Both teams seem to be, maybe because it's their first game of the weekend, I don't want to say hesitant, but they're certainly waiting to size up the pitcher and see what kind of stuff he's dealing, like on that nice put-away pitch there.
Batting number two.
And Tyler Perez strikes out on a high fastball, which brings up number 10, third baseman, Alex Rodriguez. I'm sure he goes through school known as A-Rod, as he certainly has a famous baseball name.
Well, he was great there when Rodriguez stepped into the box. You saw the catcher stand up and direct the troops out there. He put on the shift. It didn't come from the managers, but it came from the man behind the plate, the catcher.
He directed
the guys to all take a couple of steps to their right and put the righty batter shift on, certainly compared to what they had for the first batter who was hitting from the other side of the plate.
A very alert team, the young men in blue. And that's strike three on a ball that may have been a little bit inside. Our vantage point here is up and above the screen behind home plate. And we're looking down at the umpire, the catcher, and the batter. And it's sometimes just a little difficult to see where the ball crosses the plate. But that one certainly did, for a swinging strike. Whatever young Mr. Huang is throwing up there, it's obviously hard to hit because there we go to an 0-2 count.
That was a heck of a pitch. He completely fooled the batter. He was stepping out of the box thinking it was way outside.
And that's strike three, and that's the inning.
Absolutely dealing that inning. Last two batters, three pitches each, two outs. So for a total of an 11-pitch inning, he had a fantastic set out there on the mound. Wally, can you talk a little bit about pitching from the stretch? I just noticed that the Chinese Taipei pitcher, Huang, was pitching from the stretch with no runners on. Is that just a personal preference, or is that something that at this level is fairly normal for the young guys?
He may have been coached to do that. That may be part of their whole training program. Maybe for someone his age, it just gives him a better sense of balance. Ladies and gentlemen, while we're between innings, I want to mention to you that we are coming to you by the courtesy of the MCAET, the Media Center for Art, Education, and Technology. And this baseball game from the Bronco World Series is being televised by Comcast Channel 26. And this is a division of the Monterey Office of Education Broadcast. Go to MCAET.org.
Wally, what do you think? Pitching's going to be the key today?
I'm waiting to see the first hit, Matt. So far, we've had one base runner.
And Chinese Taipei, you're right, threatened in that first inning and drawn a six-pitch walk in that first at-bat. And then after that, stole second but didn't do anything else.
Here we have number six, Su Hua Ye, who's the center fielder, batting left-handed. The third baseman pulled in tightly, thinking about a possible bunt. Pitch was low, ball two. And fouled off into the screen. Brings up 2-1. excellent pitch by Robert Turon. Right down around the knees. And so we have a 2-2 count. I think that one just slipped out of his hand. He might have been trying to throw some sort of breaking ball or a changeup.
A couple of nice cuts there from the batter. See if he can make this at-bat pay off. He's been patient thus far.
Well, he's just a little late, isn't he, Matt? But he's getting around on it.
It looks like it. It looks like he's taking his time to size up the speed of that ball. And he's been patient and picked his swings. Like you said, he's just a little bit behind.
And there's the first ball hit in fair territory. Fly ball to the left fielder. Easily handled out there.
An easy put away out there for the left fielder. I believe that's Andre Sanchez, number 9 for Tamiami.
That was Andre Sanchez who made the catch in left field, Matt. And here we are into the second inning. And we finally had a ball hit in fair territory. So the batters will warm up. And I think probably by the third or fourth inning, we'll be seeing some good hits. Number 12, Lee Chung Peng is the batter. And he's the left fielder for Chinese Taipei. Right on that outside corner.
That's been a tough pitch for the Chinese Taipei guys to keep an eye on. It looks like it's really tailing away and is going to be way outside and ends up catching that that outside corner.
That was a beaut. There's another one. Robert Turon seems to be all around the plate on all his pitches. Except for one batter, he has shown no symptoms of wildness. He's trying to keep the ball low, which he just did, but about a few inches too low.
And Wally, I got to say, I am impressed with the patience of those Chinese Taipei batters. They're really making him work every at-bat that they're in there.
Another foul ball. They don't swing at balls out of the strike zone, Matt.
Not so far, anyway. That shows discipline. That shows training. That shows maturity, perhaps beyond their years of their 12-year-old, of their 12-year experience at the plate.
Couldn't agree more. Full count. That pitch was low. But as long as Turon keeps the ball in that general vicinity, he'll be in good shape. Here's the full count pitch. Fouled off down the first baseline. Count remains 3-2. Top of the second. No score. The team from Tamiami, Florida, against the team from Chinese Taipei. A squibber off the end of the bat, fielded nicely by the first baseman. That had some English on it.
That was a heck of a job of fielding with that ball coming off with such rotation. That could have easily been mishandled down there, down the first baseline. Nice job of staying relaxed by the first baseman, keeping the ball in front of him and just finishing the play.
So far, he's had two balls to handle, and he's done well with both of them. Ground ball to the shortstop, up and over to first, and now he's had three balls to handle. Had to do a little stretch on that one. 1-2-3, top of the second.
And Chinese Taipei got that one runner on first, stole him down to second. Looked like we were going to see a little National League ball strategy there in the first inning. Second inning, they weren't as lucky to get a guy on the plate. Looks like the pitcher for Tamiami, Robert, has settled down. And Turon looks like he's finally found his groove out there and had only a 13-pitch inning. That compared to his 22-pitch first inning, big, big, big difference there.
I was thinking, Matt, that compared to the previous games played yesterday, which were high-scoring affairs, including one that was the mercy game, mercy rule game, for those of you who are unfamiliar with that, if one of the teams is ahead after five innings by more than 10 runs, the game is called off, and the team in the lead is considered the winner. The rationale behind that is really quite simple. If the score is 14 to nothing, that's enough for one day. We certainly don't want to embarrass anybody. Matt, I see Kevin Merfeld from the Monterey Herald. He just waved to me. I think he's sitting right over there in the top row.
He sure is.
To the far right.
He was here covering yesterday, the opening day of the games, three games as well as the opening ceremonies.
He does
on the first day.
He does a great job reporting for that newspaper.
For Tamiami, Florida, catcher number 17, Pedro Pages.
Now, here's the catcher that I was talking about that is doing a great job directing the troops for Tamiami from behind the plate. Let's see how he handles himself in the box on that first pitch. It was inside, ball one.
Number 17 at bat, the catcher, Pedro Pages. Ooh, nice, knee high. I think Pedro would like to have that one back. Good pitch to hit. Just low.
Ooh, that's a good eye. Good eye by the catcher there to lay off that one. It looked like his knees buckled a bit. He was ready to take a rip at it, but held off.
I'm surprised at how many of these batters are taking as many pitches as they do.
I couldn't agree more. Woo. I think the pitch counts are going to be up for both pitchers. And it's going to be, it certainly seems in the early going, totally different than some of the scores we saw yesterday. That's a great piece.
That ball was hit off the wall over the right fielder's head. And there's the first hit of the day. The Tamiami catcher drilled one to right field. I think the right fielder was caught a little bit by surprise because the ball wasn't hit that high, but it certainly got over his head in a hurry.
Well, it line-drived right into that right field fence. I mean, another 10-12 inches higher, that thing is a home run. But it was certainly a misjudge by the right fielder. I think he thought he was in for something else.
So we have the Tamiami first base runner. The batter now is the Florida shortstop, J.C. Barrios, number 25. I'm beginning to think that one or two runs might be about all it would take to win this game.
And Wally, what do you think that is? Maybe a little first game jitters?
I'm sure. These teams traveled a long way to get here, too. Might have a little jet lag.
Yeah, keep in mind, we're seeing the best of the best. We're seeing regional champs here. We're seeing national champs. We're not seeing someone who just put together a couple of wins to get here. These teams have been playing for months to get here, or weeks, certainly. And we're seeing the best of the best.
And the way those pitchers are demonstrating that today, proves your point.
Seems like both pitchers are attacking the outside corner against the right-handed batters. They're really trying to paint stuff on that outside edge and really make the hitters make the decision as to whether or not they're going to lay off.
Foul ball.
Oh. Boy, that was going to be a heck of a nice double play there if it had been ruled fair. But what a heads-up play by the first baseman to glove that step on the bag, and almost without thinking about it, fire on down to second.
That ball is the home plate umpire's call until it crosses first base. Then it becomes the first base umpire's call, and he correctly made it. Ball was fouled off the batter's foot.
Both teams have a great presence in the stands from their fans for today. Looks like both teams travel well. I'm certain it's a lot of family members, but they're dressed in their team colors. They're waving their team flags. And Chinese Taipei has the international support all the way here in Monterey, California.
Low and away for a ball. I would think, Matt, that the parents of the Tamiami boys would love to come to 62 degrees in August.
I think that's the case for all teams, Wally, really.
Ball four.
Ooh.
Well.
That's a great patient at-bat. Once again, we keep talking about the patience of these batters. But that was a heck of an at-bat by number 25 for Tamiami. That's J.C. Barrios. And for him to stay in there and end up drawing a walk out of that, now they've got guys on first and second. And maybe the first real chance of a threat here, signified by the fact that the manager for Chinese Taipei has come out. I believe that's Cheng Ta Lee. And he's having a chat now with the catcher and the pitcher, talking to them about how they're going to handle this situation with runners on first and second.
This is certainly the closest thing we've had to a rally. A single off the wall and a walk. And now we have number four, the right fielder, Ryan Margolis, who takes a strike.
And the pitcher for Chinese Taipei delivers right there on cue. A little chat with the manager, comes off nice first pitch strike to set the tone for this at-bat.
Ooh. High fastball. Margolis.
Now he set himself up in a really good position here. The 0-2, now he's got an 0-2 count on him, a count in his favor. He maybe can get a little cute with some pitches here, see if he can get this guy to catch or to swing on something.
Strike three. A
that
breaking
is a heck
ball
of a
at the
pitch
knees.
On the inside. Three pitches. Three strikes, and really got himself back. Now calmed down after getting those first two runners on, and he's looking phenomenal. It looks a little more calm there.
First out of the inning, Matt.
Interesting batters checking the signs from the coaches both at first and at third on that one. Not sure. Usually it's the third base coach that's going to deliver the instructions, but on that one he was swinging away for a swinging first strike. What's interesting, I'm not sure if they're picking this up on camera, but the Tamiami runner who's at second is making some kind of motion with his hands when the pitcher goes back to check on him. He's swinging his hands around.
Oh.
And I'm not sure what that's about, but Su Sua Huang, the pitcher for Chinese Taipei, is obviously not fazed by it.
No.
And he delivers called third strike to that at bat.
Pitcher number 26, Robert Turan. Batting eighth in the Tamiami lineup. Boy, he is just pumping strikes through there, isn't he?
Man, and he's attacking that outside corner. It's got to make the Tamiami players a little worried. Now they probably are thinking that they're going to have to swing at stuff that seems outside to them. And there's a perfect example of it there.
Exactly. I don't know what the Chinese Taipei coach said to his battery, his pitcher and his catcher, about 5 minutes ago, but whatever it
there
was.
It is. Wow, what a response. Talk about he gives up a shot there to right with the first batter, then a six-pitch walk to the second to get first and second with no outs. Manager calls him over. They talk for about a minute tops, and he responds with three straight strikeouts. I mean, what a response for that kid.
Absolutely. Well, we have a scoreless game, ladies and gentlemen. Two well-played innings. And I'd like to remind you at this point that we're brought to you by the Media Center for Art, Education, and Technology. And also, we're brought to you by Comcast Channel 26. MCAET is a division of the Monterey Office of Education.
Well, we're certainly thankful to all of you that are tuning in on Cable Channel 26 or perhaps MCAET.org. That's MCAET.org. Wally, a wind not really a factor here today. I thought that maybe down here in Monterey at this time of year we might see a little bit of a stiffer breeze, but it seems to be gusty. Blowing almost near straight out to center field. But as we said, a lot of the guys not swinging at a ton of stuff, so it hasn't been a factor, certainly thus far with the balls that are hit, because there haven't been many balls hit.
No, I think there have only been three or four balls hit into fair territory, one of which rattled off the wall in right field. One was a pop-up to left. We've had a ground ball. Actually, two ground balls to the shortstops. Overall, a game dominated by the pitchers. We are all ready to the top of the fourth inning.
And I wonder if that two-run lead is going to be enough. Certainly from what we've seen thus far, with not too many runners in scoring position, not too much contact with the pitches, maybe that two-run lead will hold up. Certainly totally different story from yesterday's games that were all high-scoring with a team, I believe, scoring no fewer than five runs.
Matt, correct me if I'm wrong, but I don't think there's been an error in this game. I don't think there's been anything you would call a misplay or a mistake.
I certainly haven't seen one, and that speaks to the discipline and the training and the dedication that these players have to be out there. They've just fielded flawlessly as that first pitch is just outside for a ball.
The batter is number six, Su Hua Ye, the center fielder. All the plays that have been made flawlessly.
And the infield defense has been strong for both teams. They've kept balls in front of them. They've knocked them down, and they've fielded them cleanly and sent them over, usually for the out at first base.
I've been very impressed with the Tamiami shortstop, who's made at least two excellent plays. J.C. Barrios, accurate throws to first base.
Now coming back left fielder, that's number 15.
And number six, Ye just walked, and now we have... We have a pinch hitter. Yu Chen hitting for Li Chung Peng here in the top of the fourth inning.
Interesting move to pull in a pinch hitter here with a two-run lead and a runner on first. Your lead guy draws a walk and you bring in your pinch hitter. Interesting move. I'm not sure if it was something that was going to happen no matter what, but
I've got a hunch, Matt, he might be a good bunter. And they're just trying to get that runner over. But if he's going to bunt, he better do it pretty quickly, because Robert Turon is throwing strikes.
And I wonder if it was a decision because he's a lefty batter.
Fly ball to left field. Easy play for the left fielder. Results in an out.
Right fielder number 7, Yu Lin Hu, at bat number 7.
I think there's a certain element of free substitution in these games, Matt. Whereas if you're taken out, you can come back later one time. Ball was fouled off by number 7, Zhu Lin Hu, who is the right fielder. I refuse to say who is the right fielder, but I've already said it. So we'll just continue with the game. Pickoff throw to first base. Not quite in time. Once again, same result. Got timeout on the field. We retrieve a loose ball. And Robert Huron has really pitched himself an excellent game, except for that one pitch he'd like to have back that was hit over the left field fence. He's had, for the most part, excellent control. Only walked 2 batters. And now he's going back to work. Foul ball. 1 ball and 2 strikes. On who? Here in the top of the fourth with Chinese Taipei leading 2-0 on a home run by the pitcher, Huang.
Ladies and gentlemen, we do have to apologize. I just got word from the truck. We had a little bit of a power outage.
Ooh,
so
we have a power
outage. Missing
outage.
Footage for those of you who are watching. But as Wally just mentioned, it is a 2-0 lead for Chinese Taipei right now. And they've got their lead batter on first.
So do we... And there's the first hit batsman of the game. Number 7 took that right in the middle of his back.
And to be honest, Wally, that's really the first mistake that we've seen today by either team, defensively speaking.
How many balls have we seen go to the backstop?
0. No fielding errors, and that's really the first mistake that we saw today. And that one came from the pitcher.
Well, folks, after numerous efforts on the part of our tech squad, we now have a color monitor currently showing me exactly what you're seeing on your screen, but I know we have 4 cameras here, so we'll be getting comprehensive views from center field, first base, third base, and behind home plate. Meanwhile, Chinese Taipei, runners on first and second. Number 2 is the batter, Chung. Sio Chen Chung throw to first.
Oh,
beautiful throw by the Tamiami catcher. Pedro Pages, spells it P-A-G-E-S, could be Pages.
What a heads-up play, really, Wally, on that one, to pay attention, to see the runner had wandered off first base, and after the pitch, just to deliver basically a strike right out there to first base.
Absolutely broke the back of whatever rally it was we were having. And there's that sure-handed shortstop. Once again, impressive. J.C. Barrios on a 6-3. And quite impressive young man who's fielded that position flawlessly from the very beginning. We remain 2-0. Chinese Taipei in the lead, and we're going to the bottom of the fourth inning. Tamiami's back at the top of their order. And as soon as Matt and I figure out where Tamiami is, we'll report it to the viewing audience. We looked it up last night on my road atlas, and we couldn't find, I know where Miami is, but this is T-A-M-I-A-M-I. We thought it might be a combination of Tampa and Miami, but that doesn't make much sense because Tampa's a 3.5-hour drive from Miami. It's on the opposite coast. So perhaps sometime during this telecast, we can find out exactly where Tamiami is and report it to you.
Wally, I got to say, it's a great place. This has been fantastic baseball. If you've never, for anybody watching, watching this broadcast, if you've never been down here to Jack's Park, you've never had an opportunity to come in the last 18 years that it's been here, this being the 19th annual, it's just good baseball. Whatever preconceived notions you have about 12-year-olds playing baseball, I think have been put to rest by what we've seen yet again. It's good quality baseball, offensively and defensively.
That is so well said, Matt. I couldn't agree more.
I think some people will balk at the idea and say, well, it's 12-year-olds. What do I want to go see that for? But it's been just a joy to watch some guys that obviously take it seriously, and it shows in their performance.
All right, at bat we have number 17, Pedro Pages, the catcher who doubled off the wall, or singled actually off the wall earlier. And you know, Matt, I see one of the fathers of the Tamiami players, Mr. Margolis, down there in the blue jacket. And we're going to get to him and find out where Tamiami is. He's down there with his camera.
There it is again, attacking that outside corner against the right-handed batters. All the guys have been laying off it. The guys who are in the batter's box have been staying away from even taking his chop at that. But it's been consistently called by the home plate umpire all day.
And this is the inside for a ball. This is the only batter on the Tamiami team who has actually reached out and hit that outside pitch to right field when he hit it off the wall.
With that kind of strike zone, I have to think it really favors the pitcher. If he knows he can attack that outside, there aren't too many right-handed batters that are going to be able to turn on that and get a good hit on it.
Well, we
but
have
as
a
he
walk.
Goes a little bit too far outside on that one and gives up a leadoff walk.
Shortstop number 25, J.C. Barrios for Tamiami. Barrios at the plate.
If J.C. Barrios is as good a hitter as he is a fielder, he ought to have himself quite a future because he can gobble him up at shortstop.
I think it's a name we've got to remember, certainly coming out of Florida on the high school level in the next couple of years, but maybe perhaps even on the collegiate or the professional level. He's a heck of a player. As we take a break here and the managers come out, the first base coach is coming down to talk to him, perhaps about what he's going to see here with a runner on first. And at the same time, the Chinese Taipei manager coming out to have a conversation. Now, the last time this happened, the pitcher really settled down, delivered 9 straight strikes for 3 consecutive strikeouts after Tamiami got the lead two runners on.
Well, let's see if history repeats itself. Seeing young Mr. Barrios from Miami, a shortstop, of course, reminds us that, ooh, that's curving, but it's going to remain fair. Runner from first, digging for third, and he makes it. And now the young men from South Florida have a real rally going. We just talked about his potential as a hitter. That was well placed.
That was a great shot down there to right. And the shift had been on. The right fielder the right fielder was over towards center field.
Sure was.
And he had a lot of ground to cover. He just couldn't get there in time.
So we have first and third and nobody out. And this has the makings of a great inning for Tamiami. They've got to get at least one run out of this. Whoops.
Nice double pickoff fake there.
The old fake to third, fake to first play, which I absolutely do not like. But he's obviously been watching the major leaguers who do it. Low and inside for ball one.
It's going to be interesting to see if Su Sua Huang, the pitcher for Chinese Taipei, continues to attack the outside corner. Now that he's got a runner in scoring position, another right-handed batter at the plate. Let's see if he keeps it outside and forces the batter to make a decision.
You know, Matt, this is the first time today he looks a little flustered.
Ooh. I couldn't agree, and he's changed his strategy. He's coming inside now on the last couple of pitches. That one fooled the batter, but he's coming inside instead of attacking outside. But it also could be a strategy move, and he could be setting the guy up. He could be now ready to deliver on that outside corner and go back to his bread and butter, which has been that outside corner all afternoon.
Ooh. A breaking ball as Barrios steals second base. So now, with the count at 2-2, nobody out, young Mr. Castillo needs to put the ball in play.
Runners on second and third. Tamiami has to be licking their chops here, thinking that this is an opportunity to cut into that two-run lead, if not totally erase it, as that pitch looked like he was trying to go back outside but went a little bit too far for a ball.
Two balls, two strikes is what I see. And the pitch. Oh, high and away, but he went after it.
And that's just what we were talking about. He said, you know what, I'm going to make this batter make a decision. I'm going to deal him something too far outside, but let's see if it tempts him enough to get the bat off his shoulder. And sure enough, third strike. It was a nice move, and now into the box steps number four. Looks like Ryan Margolis for Tamiami.
And now that we're down to the bottom of the order and the infield is playing in, it's incumbent on young Mr. Margolis to put that ball in play somewhere.
Time called as we had a tennis ball on the field out there and right. Gives the pitcher a chance to catch his breath here and perhaps settle down, see if he can get himself out of this second and third with two outs.
At least it wasn't a beach ball.
Oh, boy.
Pop up to right. Right fielder is under it, makes the catch. The runner tags up and scores. Well, we have a 2-1 ball game.
No relay there. They got the ball to the infield as quickly as possible, but the runner was just too far advanced, coming from third after the tag up. But Tamiami's got to feel pretty happy about that. Now two down, runner on third, and they were able to cut that deficit in half, 2-1. And now the pitcher coming to bat for Tamiami.
That's right. And by the way, heads up runner, heads up base running by the runner on second, who Barrios, who continues to do things well. Ooh.
And you get a hit here, and you're back to even. It'll be a 2-2 ball game. But let's see what kind of patience Tehran can exhibit here in the batter's box.
Yeah. Well, he started him off with an off-speed breaking ball, inside corner. Now he just threw a fastball in the outside corner.
He keeps going right back to that, and the umpire is giving him the benefit of the doubt outside there.
He's got him 0-2.
Catcher sets up outside.
Whoa.
But just enough outside to be to the batter's advantage for a ball.
When you see 12-year-olds throwing waste pitches, the sophistication of the game, that's going to drop, I think. No. Right fielder made the catch.
Yeah, but Wally, Tamiami able to get a run there. They got second and third with only one out. Were able to capitalize on it, cut the deficit in half. Now you got a one-run ball game. Going to see how Chinese Taipei responds to that.
Well played all around. Mr. Margolis is right there. Ladies and gentlemen, we are on a mission to find out where Tamiami is. And hold on 1 second, please. And my able partner here, Matt Aruda, has headed out to talk to the father of one of the Tamiami players to see if we can discover where this mythical location is. I thought I knew my South Florida geography, but apparently I don't know it as well as I thought I did. Ladies and gentlemen, we are coming to the top of the fifth inning already in this beautifully played ball game, 2-1 in favor of Chinese Taipei. Both starting pitchers are still in the game, and Matt is back with
our research and development team is reporting back to me. that is, in fact, a team based in Miami. Tamiami Park is a park that's in Miami, and this is the team that represents and plays at that park. It's from Tamiami Park from Miami, Florida. So it's not a town, it's not a regional team or anything like that, just a park that happens to be in Miami, Tamiami Park. And the team represents that park, and they've qualified regionally to make it here to Monterey. And right now, just cut the deficit that they faced in half. And they've got to be feeling a little bit better about their chances after that inning because, to be honest, they kind of roughed up the pitcher a bit. Not roughed him up, but, you know, we're able to get some action on the ball, get a couple hits, and get some runners in scoring position.
Oh, they showed they could hit him a little, didn't they?
We'll see how Chinese Taipei responds now in this inning.
Thanks for the research, Matt. That would explain why we couldn't find it on the Atlas last night. All right.
This looks like a substitution in the game for Chinese Taipei. Number three.
Zongqi
Chang. Hitting from the right-hand side of the plate. Showed bunt on that first pitch. And it was a strike.
I'm carefully watching Robert Turon for signs of fatigue, if any. He seems to be throwing the ball just the way he did last inning. That's a 4-3. Nice hop for the second baseman. Made it look easy.
Now, Wally, as I was not a pitcher and never have been a pitcher, I always find it interesting to watch mechanics and watch delivery. And Turon has consistently pitched not from the stretch, whereas the Chinese Taipei pitcher Huang has pitched from the stretch. And so here's Turon delivering from both feet on the rubber for a swing or foul tip first strike.
Excellent point. Notice how he keeps the ball and his glove close to his chest when he's halfway through his windup, right there. So he's hiding the ball, and he's doing a great job of having consistent, repetitive mechanics. Faces the batter, turns slightly, and then just without much... My goodness, we're seeing some excellent infield defense.
And Wally, like I said last inning, for any preconceived notions you have about 12-year-old baseball, I think will be put to rest if you take the time, come down here to Jack's Park, check it out. It's just good baseball, good, solid, fundamental baseball that we've seen thus far.
And when you have a third baseman named Alex Rodriguez make that play, it sort of puts the frosting on the cake, doesn't it? When Matt and I were driving over here from my home in Carmel earlier today, he was once again right down to Rodriguez, up with it and over to first. Boom, boom. My goodness, these boys are playing excellent baseball. Just we were fantastic. Talking about infield defense. His theory at the time was that we would see a lot. If one team had an advantage over the other, it would probably be a combination of good pitching and strong infield defense. Well, we've only had four balls hit to the outfield. Actually, five if you count the home run, which was beyond the outfield.
A little past the outfield. But I think the left side defense that we've seen so far has been phenomenal. The shortstop and third baseman on both sides really have been fundamental. They watch the ball into the glove. They get it set. They set their feet, and they deliver essentially a strike right over to first base.
Well, Alex Rodriguez there had back-to-back plays, two totally different types of balls.
Yeah.
One was the high bouncer, which he was patient for, took it on the good hop.
Mm-hmm.
Second was hit much harder, was a grass skimmer, and he stayed down on it. As you say, watch ball in the glove.
And think of the confidence that gives a pitcher. A pitcher knowing that, fine, if the batters are going to figure me out and get a piece of stuff, but if I can get them to keep it on the ground and hit infield grounders, knowing that he's got that defense to back him up and still get that guy out at first, that way the pitcher can say, big deal, if you get a piece of it like we just see here, and the pitcher able to play defense and get it right back over to first, that's a lot of confidence for a young pitcher.
Absolutely. Gus Miranda just grounded out, the leadoff batter. In the bottom of the fifth, a 1-3. Nice play by the Chinese Taipei pitcher, reaching up, grabbing that ball, making the good throw to first.
Tamiami sending here we go. We're going to see their left-handed batters now coming up to the plate. At least, I believe, two in a row.
Their number 9 and their number 1 are lefty. And we have the center fielder, Tyler Perez.
Big swing there on that first pitch. Swing and a miss on strike one. First ball to the backstop was right
first
there.
First ball to hit the
Wally
backstop.
He mentioned it last inning, said, how many have we seen at the backstop? Count on the day, 1.
This has been an interesting ball game. You always see something different in every single ball game you go to, but
to draw some major league comparisons, if we had to make broad generalizations, yesterday turned in a bunch of American League type scores,
yeah.
And so far today, a National League type game at only 2-1.
Yep, yeah. And we're already in the fifth inning. Bottom of the fifth. Well, Zhu Huang is still putting the equivalent of Chinese Taipei mustard on that ball.
Almost on cue, we've now seen two of the last four pitches end up into the backstop. It doesn't detract from the game that it's been thus far and the quality of play that we've seen, however.
I'm noticing his stride as the innings go by. He seems to be striding farther. Another unbelievable play by an infielder, a 12-year-old infielder, just went in the hole, gobbled that ball up, and made a great throw to first.
Now the third baseman, Lou, was playing
right.
Really in on the infield grass on that one, and he just didn't have the time to react. But once again, shortstop and left side of the infield defense has been phenomenal.
There is, just as we say it, there's the first. I don't know if I'd be interested to know how the official scorer scored that one.
I would call that an error, in my humble opinion. I think that was a playable ball. It wasn't a hot shot down the line. It was hit fairly softly, and I think it was just a bobble. Looked like the third baseman maybe lost his footing, ended up trying to field it off his knees, and instead redirected it.
Well, I have to assume that eventually we would have an error, considering the ages of the players. But
interesting, this is Andre Sanchez, number 9 for Tamiami in the box now. He starts with an open stance. Looks like he's got his left foot way out, and on the windup and delivery from the pitcher, steps into it and tries to set his feet. Looked like a pitch out there, maybe thinking that the runner was going to go from first. Not sure if it was by design a pitch out, but it certainly looked like one.
Well, he's a swing and a miss, but the ball was not fouled, and the runner took second base. And that's the tying run.
It was really a half-hearted swing there from Sanchez. Looked like it just a defensive one trying to get a piece. But that one was a real one, and he goes down swinging.
And that's at the end of five innings. We have Chinese Taipei 2. And the young men from Tamiami Park, Miami, Florida, have one run in this beautifully played ball game.
An interesting thing that we're not seeing on the monitor, but that's happening at the end of every defensive stand for Chinese Taipei. The manager is sort of huddles this guy right in front of all of his guys who come off the field right in front of the dugout. They have a quick conversation, perhaps a little criticism, constructive criticism about how the inning went defensively. And then the players work their way into the dugout after that. But every player hustles off, stops there to have a chat with the manager, and then after that is allowed to return to the dugout.
By the way, the next time they do it, notice that the end of the manager's brief discourse, all the players bow to him.
Clearly a sign of respect. They obviously respect him as a manager. But to be honest, he's managed a heck of a game thus far, I think, from a defensive standpoint. I think they've made all the right plays. That one little blip that we saw on the radar was when Tamiami got the runners on early and did what they had to do by advancing the runners and then the sacrifice to right to score the one run. But you got to think he'd be pretty happy to hold on for a 2-1 win at this point with a one-run lead this late in the game.
I was thinking, Matt, that maybe this winter when you're coaching your basketball team, you could teach them how to bow after the timeout huddles.
That would certainly be something unique in the area. I haven't seen any basketball teams do that, and I've coached my fair share of games against any number of teams. No one has bowed coming out of one of my timeout or halftime discussions yet. But first time for everything. We'll see what happens. Now as Chinese Taipei sends number 9, Chi Lang Chu to the plate.
Lang Chu.
See if they can add to their one-run lead.
Who is their catcher, an impressive player, right on the outside corner. We have a new pitcher.
That is, in fact, I believe, if I'm not mistaken, the center fielder for Tamiami, number 3, Tyler Perez, who has stepped in to assume pitching duties. He is continuing to attack. It looks like the strategy is to attack that outside corner and see if he can get some help from the home plate umpire.
Well, young Mr. Turan ought to be very proud of his performance today. He pitched 5 innings, gave up 2 earned runs. That one home run cost him. But other than that, he was a pretty stingy right-hander.
He had a great game. Didn't get rattled and stuck to his game plan. And as you said, that repetition and that routine that he had was something he could rely on there from the rubber.
That ball hung up high and was drilled. Up the alley, left center field.
First baseman, Zhu Lang Wong, number 11.
I'm surprised the play at second was even that close, to be honest, Wally. The ball was hit pretty hard, but the batter got on his horse there and motored into second. And actually, it looked like there almost was a play there at second. Chinese Taipei now trying to add to that one-run lead as a called first strike there on the outside corner.
Tyler Perez has a rather odd way of delivering. He cocks his arm behind his head a little bit like a catcher throwing to second base. Watch what he does. Very deceptive. He bends his elbow, puts it right behind his ear. First time an infielder for Tamiami has made an error.
And that was J.C. Barrios, the shortstop, who we were speaking about earlier. In his defense, it was hit pretty hard. And he was able to knock it down, keep it in front of him. He kept the runner on second, looked him off, and then still tried to deliver to first. It just wasn't in time. But he saved, instead of runners in the corners, it's now first and second.
Chinese Taipei is mounting a serious threat here. Nobody out. Runners on first and second. And number six squared away to bunt.
Now the third base coach for Chinese Taipei, pretty animated on that. I'm not sure if there was perhaps a miscommunication on it, whether he gave the bunt signal or didn't. But it looks like a little bit of a miscommunication there. It almost cost them their runner at second, really.
Oh, popped up foul on the bunt. Nice hustle by number 17, Pedro Pages, the catcher.
And that's Su Hwai Ye, number six, who's hitting from the left-hand side of the batter's box. Was showing bunt on that one. I have a feeling that the bunt is off now. We're going to see what he can do. Had a good eye there to lay off that one. Pass ball, I believe. Not a wild pitch.
One or the other.
And advances the runners.
Looked like a pass ball. The runners advance. So young Tyler Perez now finds himself in deep trouble. But he strikes out number six. Yay. That's a big out for him.
That, of course, the first out of the inning. Now it's second and third with one out for Perez. And now number 12 stepping in.
Lee Chung Peng, who was pinch hit for earlier, but under these rules, a squeeze play and a classic. And the second runner tries to score, and he's out. What a wonderful sequence of baseball. Perfect squeeze bunt laid down. Batter thrown out at first. Runner from third scored, but the runner from second, who had a huge lead and came around third base flying, was barely thrown out at the plate.
And the batter lost his footing. He was able to get the bunt down right like he was supposed to, but lost his footing coming out of the batter's box. And there obviously no play, or he had no chance getting to first. But interesting to send that runner from second on that, basically with then a safe two-run lead.
And that was not the safety squeeze, that was the suicide squeeze. The runner on third was two-thirds of the way down the line when that ball was bunted. Despite what the scoreboard is telling the crowd, a run did score. And it's now 3-1 in favor of Chinese Taipei. And now they just popped up the number three. And we go to the bottom of the sixth inning where time is starting to run out on the boys from Miami.
Wally, what's interesting, watching the pitcher warm up in between innings here for Chinese Taipei, it's like he takes every other pitch off. Just to keep his arm loose, he's kind of soft tossing one in, then he'll take the next pitch, the next practice pitch seriously, and then kind of lays off one, and he's alternating pitches. I'm not sure if that's because we're in the sixth inning, he's trying to save his arm perhaps, but interesting, he's not really pitching every pitch.
Well, unlike his counterpart, he's pitched the whole game. I don't know what his pitch count is. I'm sure his coach is going to only let him go so far.
My unofficial count has him in the upper 60s right now, coming into it. Now that, of course, an unofficial count based on our statistician here in the booth. But you got to think, 10 pitches an inning has got to be a bunch for these kids.
This will be an interesting inning for him.
It's not their last chance. It's not the last chance for Tamiami, but it certainly feels like it could be. In this case, in the sixth inning, we'll see what happens here if they can put something together. Now trailing by 2 runs.
They don't want to wait until the bottom of the seventh. They better hack away this inning. Grounder to short, up smoothly over to first, 6-3, and one out.
And on cue, they come out swinging. One pitch, one grounder, one out. Left side of the infield defense again, showing it's solid for Chinese Taipei. And the pitcher knows that he can give up some grounders, and he's still got that help behind him.
J.C. Barrios, the Miami shortstop, who's had one hit, played a beautiful game at shortstop. And if his team is going to catch up, he's got to get on base. They have to start nibbling away here. One run this inning would help them a lot. Then he hit at the same place twice in a row, and it got by the right fielder. It's rolling to the wall. And Barrios is going to keep going. Overthrew the cutoff man. That's the first flaw that I've seen in the fundamental Chinese Taipei ball.
The right fielder could have played that safe, Wally, and just kind of let it drop in. Instead, he went aggressive trying to make the diving catch. Of course, he missed it, and that cost him at least an extra base, if not two, on that. So we'll see with one out and a triple now.
I imagine that'll be scored a triple because he did make a diving try for it. But now we have a critical run on third base. Ball's inside for a 1-0 count. Vinny Castillo, the first baseman, number 19. And Vinny needs to get wood, aluminum on the ball. Pass ball. And here comes the runner, and he is out at the plate.
Nice little high-five exchange there between the pitcher and the catcher. The pitcher almost saying, hey, my bad. Thanks for bailing me out on that one.
Chiu, the catcher, pounced on that ball. Perfect throw to the pitcher who covered. Fundamentals. There's not that much distance between home plate and the screen. I'd estimate that at maybe 15 feet, if that. The ball bounced a little bit on an angle, but the catcher was on it so quickly, made the perfect throw.
And to be honest, a heads-up play by both the catcher and the pitcher on that.
Absolutely.
The catcher to get on that ball and the pitcher to say, hey, I got to do my job and cover home here.
Ball four to number 9, Castillo. We certainly can't fault Barrios for trying to score on that play. Runs have been hard to come by in this game. And he saw an opportunity to score, and he took it. Number 4, Ryan Marshall.
approaching the plate, number four, Margolis.
And the defensive team had to function perfectly to throw him out, and they did. Ryan Margolis, number four, right fielder. He represents the tying run at the plate.
Here we go. Deja vu all over again.
Every time this happens, the Chinese Taipei picture discovers the strike zone and throws nothing but strikes.
He's now got two outs and a runner on first. Still protecting a two-run lead here in the sixth. But as per usual, manager calls for time. Has a brief conversation with pitcher and catcher. Make sure everybody's on the same page. Knows what's expected of them. We'll see how he settles in here.
Oh! Just over the first baseman's head and down the right field line. And we have runners on first and third. Now, how big is that play at home plate?
Oh, boy. That's literally a whole other ball game if they hadn't made that.
Absolutely.
If the pitcher didn't come in and cover home on that play, was able to get that second out. Otherwise, we would have had a run score there, another runner in scoring position here. So, really a best-case scenario for Chinese Taipei.
We're going to have a pitching change.
It certainly looks like it.
Well, number five, young Mr. Huang, has done a remarkable job. The catcher's going to another position. They're bringing in a different catcher, a different pitcher. So we'll sort it out here in a minute.
Multiple shifts. But, Wally, as we said before, and I feel like I keep saying the same thing, but to be honest, it's just been great baseball. And if anybody has a chance to come down here to Jack's Park, check out this fantastic display. The games are here for 7 days in a row every year for 19. This is the 19th straight year that it's been here in Monterey. And like I said, however you feel about 12-year-olds playing baseball, this is just a great display of baseball. And we're very lucky here in Monterey or the Central Coast to have the opportunity to see this every year. So come on out. There's great food, there's great atmosphere, and just great baseball.
We can only hope that the rest of the games match this one in skill level. The scores may be higher, but I've seen some skillful young men out there today.
And like you said, yesterday was a different story in the sense of the scores that were putting up, the number of runs that teams are putting up. But as we see this start to, all the substitutions sort itself out, the catcher, number nine, Chi Lang Chu, is now stepping out, took off his gear after a quick change. He's now out on the mound. And I had a chance to watch this guy warm up pregame, and he was throwing heat. I was wandering down to the dugout down the right field side. And Wally, talk a little bit about the distance here from the mound to home plate, how that difference differs from Major League, and, of course, how the speed can certainly be perceived as different.
Now, let's watch him as he warms up. Just effortless mechanics. Look at this. He just seems so relaxed, so comfortable. It's so natural for him out there. There's no effort in that delivery.
As the substitutions sort themselves out, now the second baseman, Wei An Wang, number one, is now settling into the role of catcher behind the plate.
Right.
The catcher now out as the pitcher. A couple other shifts that have happened around the field, the two most important that we can talk about.
The pitcher's the shortstop.
And the pitcher's now the shortstop playing. We're going to see how his infield defense is.
And Ye has gone in at second base to complete, as far as we can tell, the substitution. But I'm focusing in on this this young man who's been our catcher up until now. And suddenly, Chi Lang Chiu, do I have that right, Matt? Number nine, yes.
I believe so, number nine, Chiu.
Is,
I had a chance to watch him in warm-ups, like I was saying. I thought he'd be the starting pitcher, based on what I was seeing down in the bullpen. He did pitch every pitch from the stretch in his warm-up, so I don't think he's in the stretch position now just because of the runner situation. I believe that's how he pitches by default. And your favorite.
You know, he just started off with my least favorite play of all time. However, low for ball one. He only needs to get four outs to give his team a victory.
And it looks like he's still getting the dirt set up on the mound as he's comfortable with. He's still kicking around some dirt, looking like he's trying to get his feet positioned in a more comfortable position for him.
Well, he's erasing the previous pitcher's spot. Ground ball to short, over to second, out number three.
Mission accomplished. He comes in, pitches two balls,
pitches.
And gets the guy to ground out to short.
Now stop and think about that. You had a triple, a walk, a line drive to right, which sent the player who had walked to third.
And they didn't score. Squeeze.
That was a very Metsian inning.
Yeah.
That's the kind of inning that the Mets would roll out, except they usually do it with the bases loaded, nobody out, and find ways not to score.
I got to agree, and that was my analogy early on. If I had to make broad generalizations, right from the get-go, we saw some National League ball going on, and certainly compared to yesterday's scores, it almost looked like yesterday was an American League day here at Jack's Park, and today we're going to play some National League ball. But that doesn't make it any less entertaining, or any more entertaining for that matter. Just good, solid baseball. And we're really lucky to have this opportunity of seven games in 2 days that are played here, this being game number four overall of the Bronco World Series. And it's been a joy to watch.
Number three, Pilot Perez, now pitching. He also pitched the sixth inning.
Perez coming back out here now for the seventh. Struggled a little bit there in the sixth. Maybe made us wonder why a pitching change, but we'll see how he settles in here in the seventh. And to be honest, he's got to have a great inning as he delivers an outside pitch for ball one. He's got to have a good inning to give his team any chance here. Trailing 3-1 here now in the seventh.
They cannot give up any more runs, as they're just not scoring.
Perez taking a page out of the starting pitcher's book and seeing that the starting pitcher was getting the benefit of the doubt on the outside corner from the home plate umpire. Two straight pitches on the outside, both balls. Goes back to it again, this time a called first strike for two balls and one strike here in the first batter he faces in the seventh inning with his team trailing 3-1. Goes back to it there. Ball was too low, so it's going to be 3-1 now. And to be honest, the batter, which looks like Jui Lin Hu, number seven for Chinese Taipei, just been patient. He says, hey, come in here and throw some strikes. I'm going to keep the bat on my shoulder and see if I can make you do your job. And he earns what looked like a ball, but it was called a strike. So now a full count. He's bumped it to three balls, two strikes, and now here comes the payoff pitch.
Little chopper back to the mound. Easy throw. One out. A 1-3.
Tyler Perez settles down there. Just calmly fielded that ball. Looked effortless, really.
Number two, shortstop, Zio-Chin. Zio-Chin Chong. Number two, Chong.
Well, here we are in the top of the seventh. We've got one out. Chinese Taipei at bat with Chung at the plate taking ball one.
That was actually a called strike.
Was it?
It looked a little high to me, but
excuse me.
Two called strikes on the first two pitches. One that looked high and one that looked outside, but obviously from our vantage point, we don't have the same view as the home plate umpire.
Well, young Mr. Perez has decided to throw strikes. And when you consider the size of the strike zone that he has to deal with, it's really quite an impressive feat. One ball and two strikes and a foul ball.
And now he's got the batter on his heels a bit, playing defense with a one ball, two strike count. He can be a little bit more aggressive with his pitching and see if he can get the biter to bat to bite on something.
This has all the earmarks of being a two-hour ball game. With excellent pitching, excellent defense. Sharply played baseball. Good, crisp fielding, execution, another foul ball.
There it is again. Now batter's got to be on his best behavior here and looking at anything that's close. He's got to swing, even if it's just a defensive swing, to get a piece and stay alive. He can't hesitate here in the box.
And Perez delivers, and he fouls another one off.
Well, where he got a little bit behind early on, Chung has done a great job here of now making Perez earn the strikeout or earn the out here at the plate. Taking a couple good rips and stayed alive in this count, fouled a couple of them off. Pitcher now hustles out, Pedro Pages, the catcher, now out to the mound to talk to Perez. Perhaps maybe they got their signals crossed a little bit, or he's changing up something now, see if he can get an out here for two up and two down to start the seventh.
We can't look too far ahead too quickly, but I really am anxious to see what happens at the bottom of the seventh inning. Ooh, that was just high.
Couple of close pitches and Perez's body language on that, Wally. You know, the kid looked a little disappointed on that call.
There was only one person in the ballpark who thought that was a strike, and he has on the blue shirt. High pop to the first baseman. Camps under it, makes a nice one-handed catch.
Well, two up, two down for Perez, and he's almost done his job here in the seventh of giving his team the best chance to come back with one at-bat guaranteed left.
And we have a pinch. Well, he's not really a pinch hitter. It's young Mr. Yeh, Y-E-H, who resubstituted. And he started off at second base. He started off in center field, and he pops one to left, which is caught by the left fielder. And here's the bottom of that seventh inning that we were talking about.
Now let's see if it makes us sound like we know what we're talking about. But the infield defense and the defense overall by Chinese Taipei has been solid. That's going to be the key, in my opinion, here in the seventh. The last at-bat for Tamiami out of Miami, Florida. Trailing by two runs. The strategy we've seen is more National League strategy while trying to get runners on and manufacture runs. I don't see any reason for them to go away from that strategy other than the fact they've only been able to get one run out of it through six innings.
They had such an opportunity last inning. Hits and walks, runners thrown out at home. I hope that didn't take the starch out of their game, but we're about to see.
And exactly, sometimes those can hurt psychologically more than anything, or emotionally.
Yes.
You get all these chances, these opportunities, it doesn't come through. You don't carry your chin as high, your shoulders as far back, coming out on the field for your last chance. But their backs are against the wall. And the former catcher, now pitcher, is back on the mound for Chinese Taipei, Chi Lang Chiu. We're going to see if he continues to deal. And in my opinion, throws a heck of a pitch as a presumably their closer. We don't really have a middle reliever when you're only playing seven innings. You have your starting pitcher, you hope for the best, and then bring in your closer and see if he can accomplish what he needs to do.
And here we go, folks. Bottom of the seventh, 3-1 Chinese Taipei. First pitch is low and away for a ball. I want to remind you quickly that this game has been brought to you by the Media Center for Art, Education, and Technology and Comcast Channel 26, which is a division of the Monterey Office of Education. And on the computer, we will stream MCAET.org. And now to the business at hand. One ball, one strike, nobody out. And I lost a strike in there while I was doing the commercial. Now Miami is facing a lot of difficulty. No base runners, two runs down.
But this is the top of their order, Wally, and we'll see if these guys pay off here.
I'd make him throw a few.
Oh, absolutely.
I think I'd make him work a while. Make him throw strikes. Let's see what happens.
If nothing else, a little psychological warfare and just keep the bat on your shoulder for a few pitches.
Well, counts 2-0. Maybe he listened to us.
Not sure our voices carry all the way down to the field from here, but who knows?
A little telepathy going on up here. We just want to have some excitement, maybe some base runners.
That's a nice-looking pitch. To be honest, that looked the same as the second pitch of the at-bat. However, one a ball, one a strike. So two balls and one strike now.
Every pitcher today, foul ball off the screen, counts 3-1 according to the scoreboard. I don't think that's right.
I believe it's 2-2.
I think it's 2-2.
I could be wrong, but I believe it's 2-2 with a called third strike and a swinging foul ball, which the home plate umpire now signals.
Now it's 3-2.
So it is, in fact, a full count.
You were right. Started to say that every pitcher today has been around the plate, and that makes the game move so quickly the way it's supposed to be played. Well, there's a base runner for Miami.
There it is, Tyler Perez, who's the pitcher throwing right but batting left. His patience there in the box earns him a six-pitch walk.
Number 10, Alex Rodriguez, the third baseman, who has one hit today. Took a good cut at that one. Miami needs base runners.
So this is the tying run. Rodriguez represents the tying run now at the plate.
That's correct. Change of speed.
Nice job pulling the string there by the pitcher. Had the batter fooled.
I'm so impressed with the way these pitchers have handled themselves. Whoa.
Rodriguez may be feeling a little bit of the pressure there. Three pitches,
ooh,
three strikes. A three-pitch strikeout for Rodriguez. Maybe feeling the pressure now.
He seemed over-anxious, Matt.
He did.
He was way out ahead of those off-speed pitches.
And here's the left fielder, Andre Sanchez, number 9. He represents the last chance for Tamiami.
Well, Mr. Chiu just keeps throwing strikes. Counts 1-1.
Pitcher not too worried about the runner at first, instead choosing to deal with the obligation at hand here in the batter that represents the tying run at the plate.
Bottom of the seventh, two outs. Check swing by the batter, and the count's 2-1. Chinese Taipei ahead by a score of 3-1. Tying run at the plate. And he keeps putting that ball knee-high in the outside corner.
And it looked like he just blew that one by him.
It's just a tough pitch to hit. Ground ball to the right side, scooped by the second baseman, thrown to first, and this ball game is over.
And that last play was there indicative of what we've been talking about all afternoon.
Exactly.
Solid infield defense, no panic from the second baseman, let that ball, watched it right into his glove, and delivered it down to first.
What an extremely well-played ball game, everybody. Matt and I were tremendously impressed